This screencast covers the materials from Module 3, Lesson 6, where we subtract fractions, unlike fractions, from mixed number minuends, and we'll need to regroup there. So we're going to show you a couple ways to do that. Okay, they're offering Method 1 and Method 2. We'll show you both ways to do it. It may seem that these methods are not really all that different, but as you proceed through the modules, you'll find that this leads into some interesting ideas when we get to more complex numbers. So first we're going to model with two rectangles our mixed number. And we have 1 1/3. So we're going to partition the second rectangle into thirds. We have 1 whole and 1/3. Okay, now we want to find our common denominators, so we're also going to partition this part into thirds, so our 1 whole becomes 3/3. Next, we're going to partition it going horizontally so that we find our halves. We can see that now we have a common denominator of 6. So what do we have here? If we look at this, we're going to take our 1 1/3 and we're going to decompose it into its sixths. So the 1 has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 parts out of 6, so 1 decomposes to 6 sixths. And the 1/3 decomposes, well, we'll look at that, it is the equivalent fraction is 2 sixths. So what we're going to do this time is we're going to take from the whole. We're going to take from the 6/6. I'm going to write the 6/6 over here once again so that we have room to work and make it more clear to you. So what is 1/2? Well, if we look at either one of our diagrams, 1/2 consists of 3/6. So I'm going to cross out 1, 2, 3/6. So I have 6/6 minus 3/6 equals 3/6. Okay, what do we have left here? Well, we have our 3/6 left over from our whole. But we still have some partitions or parts of our original number not crossed out here. So we have our 3/6 plus our 2/6. And that equals 5/6. We could also do this by taking it from both of these. We're not going to take it from the whole first. I'll show you what I mean. We're, in essence, going to change our mixed number into an improper fraction. We're going to do basically the same thing. I should have labeled these 1 whole, by the way. So let's do that. Do the 1 whole here. We're going to again partition this. We're going to take our whole and break it down into thirds. Again, we're going to now account for our subtrahend, 1/2. Now, in this case, we're going to look at our original problem, and that is 1 1/3 minus 1/2. Is the same as, well, what do we have here? It's the same as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 sixths. So we have equals 8 sixths. And we're going to subtract 1/2. Let's change the 1/2 to our common denominator here. So we have 1/2 is still 1, 2, 3. So we're going to just take 3 away from our 8, and we'll just 1, 2, 3. And if we count what we have left, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 left. So our answer is 5, 6, either way we do it. Again, the first one is method 1. And the second one is method 2. Use whatever method you like best. The main reason for showing you this method 1 is that it kind of gives you the idea of a process that we're going to explore later in our module here. And I think you'll find it very helpful. For the time being, though, use what you're most comfortable with. Let's do another example with both methods. Again, we're going to take and draw two rectangles, area models, to represent our mixed number, because a mixed number is greater than one. Each one of these is one whole. And the second one we're going to partition in four equal parts. We're going to bracket 1 1/4. We're now going to break this down into fourths as well. And we could have done that in either order. Now we're going to subtract 1/3, so we need to partition each one of these horizontally into three equal parts using two horizontal lines. Alright, we can see our denominator is now 12. Moving along, we're going to write our 1 1/4. We're going to decompose that. First, we're going to look at the whole. We see that that is 12 twelfths. And we'll look at our other part here on the other rectangle, 1, 2, 3. And 1/4 is the same as 3 twelfths. Again, we're going to subtract from the whole, so I have 12 twelfths. And I want to subtract 1/3. And I can see that 1/3 through this model is 1, 2, 3, 4 twelfths. So we're going to subtract 4 twelfths. X them out. And now we'll write it in our expression. We can see that we have 12 twelfths minus 4 twelfths is 8 twelfths. Now we need to add back what we have in the second rectangle, and that is 3 twelfths. If we add 8 plus 3, we get 11 twelfths. Okay, let's do it method 2. Again, we have fundamentally the same setup. We're going to partition it equally into four parts. We're going to partition it again horizontally into three equal parts. And we see once again we have our representation by bracketing 1 1/4. Okay, so now we want to determine the value of 1 1/4 using the 12th. So I'm now going to count. I've got 12 here, plus 1, 2, 3. 12 plus 3 is 15. So that becomes 15 twelfths, excuse me. Now we're going to subtract 1/3, and 1/3 is still 4 twelfths. So minus 4 twelfths. We get 11 twelfths. We're going to record that in our model by crossing out 1, 2, 3, 4. And if we look at our original whole, we have 11 out of 12. Let's do one more example. Two rectangles representing two holes. We're going to partition these into five equal parts. And we're going to partition them going horizontally into two equal parts. Again, we're going to subtract from the whole this time. So we're going to, after bracketing, 1 2/5, I'm now going to decompose my 1 2/5 into the whole is 10/10. And my fraction, 2/5, is 4/10. Again, we're going to subtract from the whole. So I have 10/10 minus 1/2. We can see from the model that 1/2 is 5 of these tenths. So we're going to subtract 5/10. And we get 5/10 left over. Indeed, this is confirmed by looking at our model. Now we have to add back our fractional part because we have not taken anything away from that. So I have my 5/10 from the whole, my original whole on the left, plus my 4/10 equals 9/10. Okay, once again, we're going to do it the second method, where we essentially change my mixed number into an improper fraction. We're going to bracket my 1 and 2 fifths. And again, we're going to partition it, going into halves, to represent our subtrahend of 1 half. Alright, so now I'm going to count up how many of these partitions equals 1 and 2 fifths. So I know I've got 10 over here. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4. So that is what? Well, 10 plus 4 is 14. So our number becomes 14 tenths. We're now going to X out 1 half. We see that 1 half is still 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. We X out the ones in the fractional part first, and we've got one more. And we cross out 1 of the 10 in the whole. So let's represent that in our problem. We have 14 tenths minus 5 tenths equals 9 tenths. You can see in either process we end up with the same answer. Again, do whatever you're most comfortable with, but I just want to again say that these two techniques will come in handy later on. You may prefer one over the other, but it's worth considering for the future. I just want to mention this one from the homework. It's the only problem like this in the whole lesson, where we have a minuend that is an improper fraction rather than a mixed number. This is no big deal. You can leave it as an improper fraction and solve it through method 2. Not a problem. Or you can change it back to a mixed number if that makes you comfortable. And of course we do that by decomposing. 9/7 can be decomposed to 7/7 and 2/7. We know that by now. Which is the same as 1 plus 2/7 equals 1 2/7. Just wanted to mention that in case that gave you a problem. And of course it just can be solved now, just like all the other problems.